Hello, wrestling fans, and welcome to episode 3 of Wrestler Weekly Memories. Hopefully you are enjoying the content as much as I have enjoyed giving it to you. And so today we talk about how in the world did we get banned from watching wrestling, from buying wrestling magazines, from seeing our favorites on TV. Well, I'll tell you, grew up Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling in the 70s, started going to matches as 1979. 1981, we moved from Lynchburg, Virginia to Jacksonville, Florida. And now we went from Bob Caudle to Gordon Solie, Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling to Championship Wrestling from Florida, summer of 1981. And now we had a couple good years there. We had a good run, my brother and I. Have a younger brother, Reggie, as you know. If you follow Wrestler Weekly, at Wrestler Weekly, we are on all social media outlets and platforms. Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, now Threads. We're out there all over the place, YouTube, Amazon. You can find the book Family Bacon Wrestling. You can read more about how we got banned. But it was two different things that really got us. One was the magazines. There was just too much blood. One particular magazine, March 1979, Inside Wrestling, my favorite magazine, had a cover with Black Jack Mulligan and Harley Race, and Black Jack has got the claw with the black glove cinched in on Harley Race's forehead, and both men are just a bloody mess. Harley's got blood all the way down his chest. My dad just didn't like that magazine. He felt like it's too much blood. And I would have been, you know, young. I was probably 9, 10, 11 years old. My brother would have been 7, 8, 9 years old. And so, you know, those bloody covers, whether it was Bobby Heenan or Nick Bockwinkel or Bob Backlund, but he just thought it was too much for his kids. And so that, mixed with Championship Wrestling from Florida and Kevin Sullivan. Kevin Sullivan, he ruined it for everybody and all of us. And I told Kevin that many times, and he just recently signed a picture to my son Miles. But the Army of Darkness, Purple Haze, the Fallen Angel, I mean, that whole cast of characters, I mean, the vignette Superstar Billy Graham, Purple Haze coming out of the ocean, I mean, I think back and it's like, wow, you know, had Kevin, I mean, just was a genius with it. But as a kid, Jacksonville, Florida, Dale Richardson, he wasn't having any of this satanic crap, as he called it. And so I thought, you know, my brother and I came home from school one day and all of our wrestling magazines were gone, missing, all of our posters, all of our signed Mid-Atlantic mags that we had gotten at the matches, gone. And for years and years and years, over 30 years, I thought my dad had just thrown them away. It wasn't until I was doing my book, Family Bacon Wrestling, that my mom tells me the honest and true story that, nope, your dad didn't throw them away. He burned them in the backyard. I said, great, that'll make for a better story in my book. But that's the deal. That's the Wrestler Weekly memory for this week, when we got banned from watching wrestling. Go to episode 2. You'll find out how we were able to come back. If you caught that, you know what I'm talking about. The Nature Boy helped out. Until next week, fans, so long for now.
Hey, y'all. What does Baby Doll do when she needs to check the facts? I go to Wrestler Weekly, the History Channel of professional wrestling.